But if you guys are working on a Nissan hard body and you put some lower end blocks in, these are 4-inch angled blocks. It's important you get angled. You've already shimmed the carrier bearing and you are still experiencing a squeaking noise or a driveline vibration. Look no further than this. There's a little cup. Oh, that's hot. Ow. There's a little cup on the drive shaft. I mean, on the trans. And that drive shaft, if you change the angle enough, the U-bolt will be physically cupping that out and grinding against it. So you'll need to chop or remove that. It's pressed in, is we are going to cut it. That way we can clear it. So if anybody's wondering about the shims, this is a 3/4-inch piece of galvanized pipe that's been coated. I've cut them 1 inch. But this will be the other thing you need to tackle. This is exactly what I was talking about, where the drive shaft was scraping. You can see the metal. We had nothing in here, this is fine. But come look in here. That right here was the sound of the cause of that issue.
Basically, that's supposed to be straight. And that's where that U-joint on the drive shaft was wearing it out. So you can either take it out or cut it and bend it out of the way.
But angled blocks to push the diff down to angle the drive shaft up. 1-inch spacers to accommodate for that angle. And that cup is now out. So yeah, hopefully that should fix it. All right, so we got Saul's freshly lowered hard body now that we fixed that drive shaft issue. Got a little bit of lifter tick that we're trying to get gone right now. We're driving it around.
I think I'm gonna buy adjustable lifters.
Yeah.
This is getting ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm tired of it too. Just the thing with adjustable lifters though is you gotta set them while they're hot. So while the motor expands, it won't be too tight. But so it might tick on like startup, but it won't tick for the rest of your drive and it'll be okay. Especially when you're romping on the gas. So right now,
the sound's gone.
She's a little bumpy because, you know, she's lowered now. But it's nothing that some Beltec shocks in the future won't fix. She rides pretty good though. She rides a hell of a lot better than mine does. Ain't that right? So we actually left with the 4-inch drop on this truck and how the suspension is right now, the life of it. I'm pretty sure a lot of the bushings are shot, but what we went ahead and did was we set this side right here, the driver's side, to 25.5 inches from the ground, lined up with the center of the wheel, from the ground to the inside of the fender. So 25.5 on this side, and then we did 25 on this side, so that whenever Saul sits in his truck, because most of the time he's the only one driving in here, it'll compress the suspension on this side and it'll actually leave the truck angled completely straight. So the bad thing about doing torsion bars in the front and just loosening them up is that you're gonna get negative camber, which you can look at it two ways. You can look at it bad or good. Personally, I love it because it helps me corner better, but it does eat through your tires very, very quickly. So we gotta go look at that water leak, right?
Yeah.
So
with the lifter tick's gone, that stupid sound is gone.
Oh, that sound was ridiculous.
I'm happy right now.
Yeah. His truck looks good. We'll walk around and show you real quick. Oh, he's lower than I am now, and I'm jealous. Saul is low to the ground. Beautiful single jingle right there. That whirring that you guys were talking about, we loosened that belt up a little bit and it started to go away. I think we need to adjust it a little bit more because I think it's still a little bit tight. But look at that. I mean, we do a re-drill on the back. I mean, his gap will be gone and we can just turn down the fronts accordingly. Guys and gals. Coolant leaks. We still got that whirring noise that we've been trying to track down from the two episodes ago when we did the walk around to Saul's hard body. We did loosen up the belts quite a little bit and it seemed to help, but it's directly matched to engine RPM, to crank speed that is. So if any of you have any recommendations, please let us know. Things to check. Saul, are you liking the lowered life?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Huge shout out to Chris Charette. He's a local guy who builds these hard bodies, and he's actually the guy who hooked us up with both of us up with our cams. Yeah. He was the one to give us the pointer about that. He was the one to give us that pointer about the drive shaft, the U-joint hitting that little dust shield.
Your drawer opened in your toolbox.
But he was the one who gave us that pointer, so thank you, Chris. Thanks, guys, for just helping us figure this stuff out. So we love the support from the KA community, the hard body guys. We're trying to bring it back to life. So if you guys like to see more of this content, please stay tuned, because we're gonna have quite a bit more videos out. I'm gonna try my best to post. I am busy, I work quite a bit, and when I'm not working, I'm at school or working on one of these. So just stay tuned. I'm not gonna tell you to like or dislike. You do as you please. If you like the video and you feel inclined to like it, go ahead. If you dislike it,
she's very loud.
She is loud. If you dislike the video, go ahead and dislike it, but just tell me why so I can try my best to make better content for you guys. So feel inclined to as well, give us a sub, and we'll be sure to have more hard body content for you. We should be re-drilling my leaf spring hangers and installing a full energy suspension and bushing kit in my truck here shortly, so we will keep you posted on that. And
comment what the next mod should be.
Yeah, comment what the next mod should be for Saul's truck as well as mine.
I'm thinking short shifter, but what do y'all think?
Yeah, we're thinking ISR short throw shifter and the heavy duty springs that go in the trans. But if you guys have any suggestions, please let us know. And we'll see you later. Peace. You can leave it up to me to never fail or cease to switch it up. I'm still smoking plenty blunts. Some say